myself Tushasha, working as GM Technical at Indian Exchange Ahmedabad, having headquarter office at Gujarat Ahmedabad, very near to airport premises. He's going to explain you and elaborate on the system which we are going to supply to ONGC Bombay at D193. I will take you to the entire routes, the way we have designed the system, the way we have configured the system, and the way we have incorporated all the third-party inspections, approvals, lot of things has gone inside the system. I myself, Tushasha, will keep on giving you the idea for each and every part of the system, one by one. This is DM plant. We have designed the systems for the flow rate of around 800 liters per hour, and the TDS, inlet TDS, which we have considered is around 500 UPI. In this system particularly, there will be a initial seawater RO systems, which would be converting the seawater around 35,000 TDS and would be bringing it down to around 500 ppm. From there on, the system, our system would take care of reducing the TDS from 500 ppm to less than 1 ppm, principally gel TDS, required as per the customer specifications. First of all, the water will enter into a disc filters. This will take care for the removal of suspended solids up to around 20 or 30 microns. So whatever in water tank there may be suspended solids, that will be taken care before it enters into our preliminary DM plant system. After passing through disc filters, it will enter into a first chamber vessels, that is strong acid cation exchangers. As the name suggests, this is consisting of strong acid cation resins inside the vessels. Around 340 liters of resins are there inside these configurations. And this will eliminate the dissolved impurities of cations like calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium, all positive ions would be reduced from these particular vessels. This is a counter current regeneration system where the water, service water, would be flowing from bottom to top, and the regeneration would be happening from the top to bottom configuration. The regeneration would be happening through a venturi based ejector system where prepared solution of acid and caustics. In this particular case, that will be a strong acid cation. There will be a solution of hydrochloric acid. So that hydrochloric acid would be sucked from a prepared solution tanks to a venturi based system configuration and will get recharged. This system is designed to produce a pure water or of around 20,000 liters of pure demineralized water. After passing through cation, water will enter into another bed that is known as strong base anion exchangers, that is known as shortly as SBA. As the name suggests, it will be consisting of strong base anion resins of type 2 categories and will ensure the removal of all anionic dissolved impurities like fluorides, sulfates, phosphates, nitrates, all those things will be removed after passing through these things. So after passing through these first two systems, your TDS would come down in the range of around 40 ppm roughly. So after passing through this anion exchangers, there will be a two sets of mixed bed anion mixed bed exchangers. First of all, after passing through anion exchangers, the first it will enter into first MB1 systems. As the name suggests, that is a mixed bed exchanger. It will be consisting of both cation as well as anion resins, and anion resins would be of type 1 category, specifically for silica removal. So after passing through anion, whatever 40 ppm TDS contained, consisting of cationic impurities as well as anionic impurities, will be removed after passing through mixed bed systems. It will be a counter current system and a downflow configurations, where water will be entering from top, will be passing through the ion exchange resins, and then will be getting purified. And after passing through mixed bed systems, you will be having itself a TDS of around say less than 1 ppm. Here, in this particular case, normally a system of cation, anion and mixed bed normally delivers the performance of less than 1 ppm. But considering the critical mass of required by ONGC systems and ONGC companies at platform, they have incorporated another mixed bed units. As the name suggests, this is mixed bed 1, and after passing through this mixed bed, it will be another small mixed bed system consisting of cation and anion resins. And again, we will be working as a final polisher units to ensure that the TDS remains zero and pH remains between 6.5 to 7.5. So this is a complete system which will ensure that the TDS comes down from 500 ppm to less than 0 ppm. Now regarding this particular system,
these particular systems can also be made in manual as well as in automatic configurations. But for this particular project, the entire system has been made in auto configurations. As you can see, these are the automatic multi-port valves. The cation and anion vessels are operated through automatic control valves, where the system itself changes from one operation to another operation, or third operation in auto mode, which is controlled through PLC, as well as through particular valves. So after passing desired quality of pure water, measured through particular flow meters, online flow controllers, the system will come into an automatic mode, will start generating the solutions, take the solutions, and will generate the entire resin bed. The same thing will happen in anion configurations. Again, the automatic configurations, the system will go into regeneration as well as rinsing mode in automatic operation. Here, in mixed bed systems, as the automatic multi-port valve configuration is not possible due to combination of both resins, we have to go for the multiple pneumatic valve configurations. As you can see, there are number of around 10-12 pneumatic multi-port pneumatically activated valves are there, which are controlled through PLC and is particularly pre-programmed to ensure that the multiple stages of mixed bed, like regeneration with caustic, separation of resins, regeneration with hydrochloric acids, regeneration with caustic soda, then again a mixing of the resins and rinsing of the entire systems, and as well as the air mixing. Entire multiple valves are there. You can see around 10 to 12 valves. This system is controlled through specifically designed PLC. It will ensure that all the operations are operated one by one by one through a pre-programmed timer-based system on PLC configurations. Similarly, for mixed bed 1 as well as for similar for mixed bed 2 configurations, all systems are completely pre-programmed, operated through PLC. Here, in this particular system, we have put up a lot of instrumentations, as you can see, through particular PLC. As you can see, this is the heart of the system, which controls the entire automatic operation of the systems. All the automatic operation of cation, anion, both the mixed bed units are controlled through a PLC, inbuilt PLC, pre-programmed PLC, as well as it is controlled through a HMI. This is made of Schneider configurations or Allen Bradley or whatever makes customer wants. We can incorporate those configurations. In this case, we have incorporated Schneider configurations. As you can see, it's entirely HMI is there, where a multiple screens would be coming, and you can control these systems either through manual operations as well as it can be put in an auto mode and system would function automatically. As I have said earlier, we have put a lot of instruments here into the systems to watch the performance of the systems and let the system works automatically. There are total 4 conductivity indicators, 1, 2, 3 and 4 conductivity indicators. First one is set at the raw water inlet to measure the intake TDS, so that whatever the client supplies, that particular TDS is measured inside those things. After passing through those, both the cation and anion chambers, there is another conductivity instrument which will measure the conductivity, whether it is becoming around 40 ppm, below that or above that. After passing through those mixed bed units, there will be individual 2 controllers like conductivity 2 and conductivity 3, which will measure the conductivity outlets of mixed bed 1 as well as mixed bed 2 units. Similarly, as particularly for DM plants, another critical parameter is the pH. So we have incorporated 2 pH units, where a pH units would be at 1 unit would be at the outlet of anion exchanges after DM plants, which normally remains in the range of 8.5 to 9.5. Through these particular instruments, we watch the performance, whether the system is running fine or not. If the pH is on the higher side, then it's an indication that something is wrong with the systems. After passing through mixed bed 2, we have put another, that is a final pure water, we have put a final pH units, which will display the final quality which is coming out from the systems. And so here you can watch the performance, whether the mixed bed unit is delivering the performance of pH in terms of 6.5 to 7.5. These are the 2 pH sensors, controllers. After passing through this, there is one more unit, that is a flow meter. This instrument also plays a very important role in terms of automation, because all the systems are designed for a particular charging operation, that after passing through pure water of say 20,000 liters for cation, after passing through anion 20,000 liters, mixed bed units 40,000 liters. So this instrument measures the continuous flow which is passing through the systems, as well as whatever the total is happening. This will measure the flow rate in terms of liter per hour as well as the totalized flow in liters. This instrument will give the signal to the panel, to the HMI, to ensure that the next stage of operations, suppose say cation exchanger has produced 20,000 liters, so it will give a, after 20,000 liters, it will give a signal
and the next stage of operations will happen automatically. So these are the instruments which we have incorporated into the systems. And as you can see, there are a number of pneumatic valves are there, ball valves are there. So it requires a separate panel enclosures for the pneumatic piping, where a client will be supplying a principal air, and then it will be internally distributed through this particular system.